Isa po kayo sa mga nag-conduct ng evaluation para sa FDA. Kamusta po? Ano yung nakita ninyo para dito sa bivalent vaccines that allowed the FDA to grant it emergency use authorization?
Okay, so there are several reasons, no? First is that the submitted document by both Pfizer and Moderna regarding bivalent vaccine elicited higher immunogenicity compared to monovalent vaccines against the Omicron variant of the COVID and that of the original Wuhan strain, no? As we remember, the monovalent vaccine only contained the Wuhan strain, but it still elicits a very good neutralizing antibody against the Omicron variant of concern. But when we compared it with the bivalent vaccine, it has a higher neutralizing antibody against the B4, B5, and BA.1. Strain of the Omicron subvariant. Second is we also review effectiveness or vaccine effectiveness data because there were two data that were from the CDC, no? The MMWR weekly report. The first one is that for those who received the bivalent vaccine, either they were already given second dose, third dose, or fourth doses of the monovalent vaccine, they were the bivalent vaccine was able to protect against symptomatic infection at least more than 50%, no? Among those who received the monovalent vaccine. So it is a very good booster doses for anybody who already have primary vaccine series or even a first booster or a second booster. The latest data was it prevented hospitalization and emergency visit or emergency care visit among those who were given the bivalent vaccine. For those who were given monovalent vaccine, again, two doses, three doses, or four doses. So all of this data are telling us that there is advantage and benefit with bivalent vaccines, especially now with the Omicron subvariants, the dominant subvariant of concern in most countries. And not only it protects us against symptomatic infection, but also it can protect us against severe infection, especially for those vulnerable population, the 65 years old and above.
Okay, just a point of clarification po. So, and if we can discuss in layman's terms, so ibig sabihin po ba nito mas mataas yung protection na naibibigay nitong bivalent vaccine kumpara sa monovalent vaccines? Yung gaano po kataas yung itinaas? I understand, parang nabanggit ninyo, so yung monovalent vaccine as booster, it gives protection against severe, yung severe symptoms, maiiwasan yung hospitalization. Parang dito sa bivalent, sabi po ninyo, kahit symptomatic na mild na pipigilan po. Kung, and I understand parang before, meron kayong mga graphs na napapakita po na ganito kataas yung itinaas ng protection. May ganun din po ba para dito sa bivalent vaccines?
Yes, the data is only telling us ang comparison kasi yung pag meron kang monovalent versus bivalent, the only comparison was the neutralizing antibody. So it has a higher neutralizing antibody, especially against B4, B5, and BA.1.
No? May percentage po ba yun, Doc?
Ang problema kasi sa neutralizing antibody, it's in numbers and figures. So ibig sabihin ang tinitingnan lang doon yung zero response, like if it is more than 50% higher neutralizing antibody against monovalent. So yun lang yung nakikita doon na mas mataas ang neutralization antibody niya over that of monovalent against the Omicron. So but remember, Vivian, no? Ang problema kasi sa neutralizing antibody, we don't use that as a correlate of protection. Anong ibig sabihin? Hindi natin masasabi na kung 3,000 ang neutralizing antibody mo, you are more protected compared to a 1,000 neutralizing antibody. But in this current vaccine evaluation, yun yung ginagamit natin ngayon na pag mataas ang neutralizing antibody mo, mas may bintahe ka, no? Dahil mas mataas ang protection. Kumbaga, an estimate of protection, predictive of protection. So, yun yung nakikita namin doon. There's neutralizing antibody ang 1:1 comparison. Pero sa real-world data, real-world evidence in terms of vaccine efficacy, effectiveness, ang nakita lang natin dito is that those who are already given a monovalent vaccine, pag nadagdagan pa ng bivalent vaccine, mas mataas ang protection against Omicron, specifically for those vulnerable population. So ang ibig sabihin nito, if we compare apples to apples, it's difficult to compare, no? Dahil ang monovalent naman, hanggang ngayon, ginagamit pa rin natin, meron din namang protection. And in fact, it has been able to protect us against severe infection. Kaya hindi masyado ang hospitalization rate natin, no? But what we want to involve here is that what if there is already waning immunity? So with a monovalent vaccine, this is where the role of another booster dose with a bivalent booster, because it will sustain and maintain its protection for those who are vulnerable against getting the infection and against getting the severe infection. So if the plan of the government is to have this in January, it's really the right time to have this during the first quarter of next year, so that our population immunity and protection will be maintained, and particularly against Omicron subvariant.
Okay. So recommendation po ba ninyo para lang sa vulnerable sectors itong bilhin na bivalent vaccine, or I mean, paggamitan itong bivalent vaccine, at least according to the EUA din po, if you would know, or at least base sa recommendation ninyo, or anyone who wants, pwede pong kumuha nitong bivalent vaccine?
Ang recommendation kasi sa FDA, Vivian, this does not indicate who are the population that will be given the vaccine. Kasi ang EUA is more on, will we approve this vaccine to be available or not approved? Parang ganun lang, no? But for the specific kung sinong bibigyan yan, it will still be the Department of Health or the HHSAC who will determine that. No? But at our level, it is based on the ability of the vaccine to protect any individual, the ability of the vaccine to mount neutralizing antibody in that particular individual, whether it's a healthy individual or a vulnerable population. But yung sinasabi ko sa iyo, I think that's only my thought na if ever we will prioritize, kasi kung halimbawa, I will give you a scenario. What if the government will only order 10 million doses of the bivalent vaccine or 20 million? Because I don't think the government will order 50 million or 80 million kasi masasayang na naman yan, no? So ang nakikita ko dito, we will prioritize the vulnerable population. And then for the other general population, it will be up to the government how they will position it in terms of giving this to the general population. Siguro, ganun siguro mangyayari niyan. It's an option. Anybody who wants the bivalent vaccine in the general population can get it. But the priority will be for the vulnerable population.
I understand. How about age, Doc? Kasi sa US, recommended to as booster for example, Moderna, 6 months to 5 years, and Pfizer, 5 years and above. Dito po sa Pilipinas, ano po ang recommendation when it comes to the age groups?
Doon sa EUA, makikita mo yon. Anyway, I'm still getting the copy of the FDA EUA. Natin-ex ko na yung si Dr. Icy. 18 years old and above ang binigyan namin ng approval for that.
So adults pa rin po?
Adults muna.
Mm-mm. And then, as booster lang po ba pwedeng gamitin itong bivalent vaccines, or pwede rin po itong as primary part ng primary series?
Ang application kasi ng Pfizer and Moderna as booster eh. So, which means that the application indication will only apply for booster.
I see. How about pang ilang booster? I mean, first and second, kasi right now, di po ba parang hanggang second booster pa lang yung allowed for the vulnerable population. But for example, yung yung immunocompromised, meron na po siyang second booster and he or she wants to avail of this bivalent vaccine. Pwede, ano po ba? Third booster po ba? Kasama po ba ito?
If I'm going to look at it this way, it should be available as first booster for the general public, for those who did not have yet any booster, the general public, no? Then it can be a second booster for the vulnerable population. Who are these? Those 50 years old and above, yung mga inapproved na natin, those 18 years old and above with comorbidities, those who are immunocompromised, and those who are healthcare workers.
Third booster, wala pa po sa usapan, Doc.
Wala pa sa usapan. We will now wait if HTAC will give a recommendation on that as a third booster for the vulnerable population.
Okay, how about safety? Pareho lang po ba yung safety or yeah, opo, yung data
Yeah.
safety
Okay.
po.
That's a good question, no? Because we also review the safety because that's one of the important data we required them to be submitted, no? So in terms of safety, the most common local adverse reaction is still pain at the site of injection and inflammation at the site of injection. There were those who had myalgia, headache, and it is also comparable to that of the monovalent vaccine of Pfizer and Moderna. So there was no safety signal. Ibig sabihin, wala naman kami nakikitang safe adverse event na unique with the Pfizer Moderna na hindi nakikita doon sa monovalent. So lahat ng nakikita doon sa monovalent vaccine na ibibigay natin are the same adverse reaction, both local and systemic, and more or less the same percentage pa rin, no? The same percentage. Hindi mas mataas ang adverse reaction, hindi rin mababa. The same, basically the same.
Opo. How about contraindications? Pareho lang din po. Walang
Yes, the only contraindication for mRNA are those who already received an mRNA and developed severe hypersensitivity reaction or anaphylactic reaction.
on the vaccines lang po, will this, I mean, this bivalent, will this be effective against BF.7? Kasi sure, Omicron pa rin po ba itong BF? Hindi na po ito
Yeah.
Omicron na po. Or
Omicron pa rin siya,
Omicron.
Vivian. It's a sub-lineage of BA.5. And remember, the bivalent has already been tested to be effective against BA.4 and BA.5. So that means that it is also expected that there will also be protection against BF.7, which is a sub-lineage of BA.5.
What do we going to this BF.7? What do we know so far dito po sa BF.7 doc base sa data na mayro available? Parang this is driving infections in China and then ngayon meron na pong na-detect dito sa bansa natin. Is this a cause for alarm po?
I don't think the BF.7 will really be a dominant variant of concern like BA.5 or BA.2, no? Why? Because BF.7 has already been reported in more than 10 countries already in other countries since June and July, yeah? And it was not able to take off as a dominant variant. Except in China, which they said is the dominant variant. And I would presume it's also expected because China has not been able to experience the Omicron surge. This is the first time that they have the Omicron. So you can just imagine a population with a low boosted population, with a low primary dose vaccine, and you will have an Omicron entering their country. You will expect a lot of transmission also of the cases. Unlike in the Philippines, we have already experienced BA.1. BA.2, BA.5, we have XBB, and now BF.7. So our population has already been exposed to some of these variants of concern or sub-variant of Omicron. And we already have some ample protection in terms of natural immunity Plastifac, there are those. So our primary vaccine rate is already around 90 million or something like that. So we are more protected population immunity wise compared to China.
Ang sabi po, just regarding this virus po, no? Ang sabi, it is more transmissible compared dun sa mga naunang sub-variants. But is that accurate? And when it comes to severity, ano po ang available data?
Yeah, it is highly transmissible because it has had it has additional 10 mutations compared to the BA.5, no? So kumbaga ang BA.5 nanganak siya to BF.7 and they look at 10 mutations, additional 10 mutations, and that makes it highly transmissible. So meaning you have a higher rate of transmissibility. In some articles, they said that the reproduction number of a BF.7 is between 10 to 18, more or less higher than compared to your BA.5. So it is expected that people with BF.7, especially those who are not yet vaccinated, will really get the infection and can transmit also to those who has not been given the vaccine or not been boosted, which is happening now in China.
Severity po, mas malala po ba ito compared to Delta kasi yan po yung medyo dumami yung hospitalization natin, Dok.
Yeah, the data from other countries aside from China did not indicate that the BF.7 drive infection and cause severe COVID and increasing hospitalization. No, it did not. But in China, they said it's driving patients to develop severe infection. And precisely it's because a lot of those are in the 65 years old and are not vaccinated.
Okay. I wonder, yung group din po ba ninyo recommended a particular number of bivalent vaccines to procure sa government or parang anlang more
It's
of
the it's it's DOH work na yan, Vivian, ang procurement. So it's the work of the US. That's why I want to know. When we had discussed that with FDA, they also didn't know how much or how will the volume or the procurement, no? But I think ang nakikita ko dito that we will not be ordering a lot of this volume of bivalent because of the threat of this vaccine hesitancy, no? We might be wasting again a lot of this vaccine. So I think it's important that the Department of Health should have an accurate assessment on what or how many of the bivalent vaccine will be ordered and who will be prioritized so that we will have less wastage of this bivalent vaccine.
Apo, yung dosage, yung nitong bakuna, and yung lifespan, kumbaga, yung bago ma-expire, pareho lang po nung mga monovalent.
Yes, pareho lang, pareho lang. Ang dosage lang magkaiba kasi ang nangyari ngayon, half-half, no? Half of the Wuhan strain and half of the Omicron strain are in that formulation.
Okay. If there's anything else you want to add, Doc, reminders sa mga mag-celebrate ngayong bagong taon po.
Yeah, it's important to remind them again, no, that we have BF.7 and might be highly vulnerable populations, especially for those with waning protection already, having their vaccine 6 months ago. Your protection against any variant of concern or strain of Omicron will really be important for you to protect yourselves by wearing the face mask and again also encouraging them to isolate themselves if they are symptomatic.
Sorry, sir, may pahabol lang yung opisina. If you would have recommendation on or parang opinion on the extension proposal to extend the state of calamity and hanggang kailan po?
Yeah, I fully agree with that, Vivian, because once we will be rolling out the bivalent vaccine, and since this is under EUA, then it's obviously we will still be giving this for free, no? Based on the EUA of a recommendation. Pag ilift mo na kasi yung state of calamity, mawala na yung visa ng EUA, paano na lang yung mga bakuna natin na we're still giving this to the vulnerable population? So I think for me, it's important that the government should also extend the state of calamity so that we can continue to give the vaccine under an EUA approval and the antiviral agents, no, can be given also under EUA.
Until mapirmahan po, no? I mean, same position with
Yes.
DOH until mapirmahan yung panukala na that will allow the rollout of these panukalang batas, yung something like CDC bill that will allow the rollout
Yeah.
of these vaccines under EU.
Yes. Correct, no? Kasi wala pa, hindi pa naman na-approve yung sa CDC. Wala pa tayong CDC. So, until such time that we don't have yet the CDC, it's important that the state of calamity will still be here. It should be extended, no? In order for us to continue with our policy in vaccinating the vulnerable population under an EUA of this current vaccine.
Doc, thank you so much.